supposed to wear a dress, but I ain't supposed to wear a dress.
So you saying that you're not finna listen to God?
I'm not saying that.
But that's what God said.
But these are women's jeans.
Are they man dresses? Is there such a thing as a man dress?
Bring it up.
What if I had like a dress and it was like a flame on it? What if it had like a lightning bolt on it and like some tiger stripes on it? Like, oh, that's real masculine right there. You'd be like, nah, that's still a dress, right? It's still a dress, right?
No.
All this knowledge about what we're supposed to do, because us not doing it is the reason why our people are in the condition that they're in today.
Right.
When you look around and you see the so-called black man, Hispanic man, Native American man inside a low estate, inside the ghettos, last hired, first fired, you know, they all these stereotypes against us. Only reason why we're in those conditions is because we did not do what God asked us to do. You got that? Deuteronomy 28:15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So this is Moses, because remember, we're saying that we're the Israelites. Y'all familiar with Moses? How Moses brought Israel out of Egypt and split the Red Sea? When he brought them over the Red Sea, he gave them commandments through God. And God said, if you do not listen to my commandments, what's going to happen?
To observe and to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
He said, if you do not listen to these commandments that I'm giving you, because I am your God and there's something that I expect out of you, then there's going to be curses that are going to come upon your people. Right? So let's see. Read the next verse. Let's read one curse that happened to the Israelites. Remember, we're talking about the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And you tell me if this curse fits our people.
Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
It said, cursed will we be in the city. You say your name, Eric? Eric? Derek, how are our people cursed in the city? What was that? Can you come closer? So can you come closer? I can't hear you. Or can you speak up? Give me one example. Do you think that the right thing is happening to our people? Do you think that we're a blessed people inside the city? Whenever you go throughout the country, you see our people. Do our people look blessed or do they look like they're cursed, something going on? What about you, V? Give me an example of how our people are cursed in the city.
Most of them like you said.
Are we shot down in the streets?
Right.
Yeah.
Are we victims of police brutality?
Yeah.
Are we the last hired, first fired? Right. Is it hard for us to land a job?
Right.
Is there stereotypes against us in the city?
Right.
That's how we cursed in the city. Read the next part.
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
It said, and cursed will we be in the field. How are our people cursed in the field, V? Think about it. Think about it in history. How were our people cursed in the field? Derek, how are our people cursed in the field? You can't think of a time where the majority of blacks and Hispanics were in a field being cursed? Slavery. Slavery. That's what God said would happen to us if we didn't listen to his commandments. Slavery. Get verse 32.
Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
He said, our sons and our daughters are going to be given to another people. When did that happen? When was it when the sons and daughters of the so-called blacks and Hispanics given to another people? You don't think that happened in slavery, Derek? Come on, Derek. Work with me, man. Work with me, man. Yes, yeah. Come on, man. Work with me. All right.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long, and there shall be no might in thine hand.
We didn't have the power to stop them from taking our sons and daughters. We didn't have that power. But get verse 47. Get verse 47. Hermano, Listen right here.
Verse 47. Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart for the abundance of all things.
Because God said that we're supposed to serve him with joyfulness and gladness, and he would give us the abundance of all things. Whenever we did that, God gave us food. God gave us water. He gave us shelter. He gave us clothing, right?
Therefore, shalt thou serve thine enemy.
But because our people didn't do that, God said we're going to serve our enemies. Right. We didn't want to serve God, so now we have to serve our enemies. In what?
Which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger.
So now God sent our enemies that we have to serve in hunger. So now if you want food, you have to go to your enemies, right? Does your people own the stores? Who owns the stores? Was it your friends? It was who? Right. God said, now if you want food, you have to go to your enemies to get it. Because if you would have served me and did what I said, I would have provided that for you. Right. But because you didn't, now you have to serve your enemies for food.
And thirst.
Water. If you want water, where you got to go? If you don't pay for your bill, who you got to pay the bill to? And if you don't, what happened? They turned it off. Read.
And in nakedness.
Clothing. Where you got to go to get clothes? The store, do your people own that? No. Read.
And in what of all things?
If you want anything, you have to go to your enemies. Education, religion, a driver's license, a death certificate, right. A birth certificate. Right. You need permission to drive a car that you bought.
That's right.
That's a curse. That's not a blessing. You can't go around looking at all that stuff and say, man, we blessed, man. We got to ask them for everything. Man, I want to go travel. You need your passport, nigga. You can't go anywhere you want. That's a curse. That's not a blessing.
Right.
But God said that we want to serve our enemies in those things because we didn't want to serve him. Read.
That's right.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
And that same enemy, so you know specifically who we're talking about, he going to put a yoke of iron on your neck. Who did that to us? Who put the yoke of iron on our neck? Right. So the Bible is very specific. Come as you are. Let's see if God says that, right? Because the problem with come as you are, sis, it means you're going to stay as you are. It's okay for you to... No, sis, listen. It's okay for you to come as you are, but you have to change. You can't come as you are and stay as you are. You have to change once you understand to do better. Because once you know better, you do better, right? Get Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Let's see. Because I want to ask you, sis, and tell me if this makes sense to you. We're going to read the scripture, right? Would you believe the scripture? Would you believe the Bible? Hey, I'm just asking. It's like a rhetorical question, right? I don't know. I have to ask you. Okay.
Deuteronomy chapter 10 and verse 12. And now, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
So if you are Israelite, God said here's something that he requires of you, right?
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways.
You have to fear God and walk in all his ways.
And to love him and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul, to keep the commandments of the Lord.
To keep the commandments of God. That's what you're required to do, V. Do you agree? So if you're not keeping, let's say you come as you are, right? And you're not keeping the commandments. Can you stay like that? So you can come as you are, but you can't stay as you are, right? So do you agree with us now? Okay, that's what we're saying. You can come as you are, that's okay. But if you stay as you are, that's not okay. Because once you learn to do better, you have to do better. That's fine. Okay, there must have been a miscommunication. That's okay. But you can't stay like that. For example, right? Get Deuteronomy 22 and 5, right? We're going to read something that God requires of men and women, and you can't stay in this way if you're doing it.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
What's a woman's garment that a man cannot wear, according to God, V? Right, because if we were all up here in dresses, you'd probably be like, I'm not listening to what they talk about. You'd be like, that'd be kind of strange, right? Because why? A man in a dress is what?
For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
So if a man came to us in a dress and we told him this, could he continue to wear the dress? He came as he was. He came as he was in the dress, but according to God, could he stay like that? No. But what did the first part say?
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
What pertains to a man that a woman can't wear? What's man clothes?
I guess baggy clothes.
Pants, sister. It's pants. It's pants. Women wear dresses, men wear pants. Women are not supposed to be wearing pants. Women are supposed to wear dresses. Read that last part of them, because all that do so are what?
For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
You see, if you do that, you're an abomination. You agreed that a man in a dress is an abomination. In the same way, a woman in pants is an abomination. So you can come here as you are in the pants, but as you learn that you can't do that, can you stay like that?
No.
So what you supposed to do?
I'm supposed to wear a dress, but I ain't
So you saying that you're not finna listen to God?
I'm not saying that.
But that's what God said.
But these are the women's jeans.
Are they man dresses? Is there such a thing as a man dress?
Bring it up.
What if I had like a dress and it was like a flame on it? What if it had like a lightning bolt on it and like some tiger stripes on it? Like, oh, that's real masculine right there. You'd be like, nah, that's still a dress, right? It's still a dress, right?
No.
That's still a dress. You know what I'm saying? So there's no such thing as a man dress. So there's no such thing as women pants. Because that pertains to men. So you can come as you are in the pants, but once you learn, you can't stay like that, sis.
Where's the zipper?
Right. Why do pants have a zipper on it? V, come on now.
Bring it up.
Come on, V. Make it make sense to us. You could, if you see a man with pants on that got zipper, you know what that zipper is for.
Right?
Because you have to unzip and, you know.
Right.
What about for a woman? Right, because it's not the same thing. It's called cross-dressing. That's why God said it's an abomination to him. But you might be saying, man, God don't care about what I'm wearing. He gonna punish me for wearing some clothes. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Let's read it.
Zephaniah chapter 1 and verse 8. And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice.
The day of the Lord's sacrifice. You believe in Jesus Christ?
All day, every day.
You believe Jesus Christ is coming back?
All day, every day.
So it says, in the day of the Lord's sacrifice, that's when Christ come back. What's going to happen?
That I will punish the princes and the king's children.
He's going to punish the princes. Remember, Israelites are the princes, the so-called blacks and Spanish. You a princess. You a princess, right? Right? He said he's going to punish them.
And all such as are clothed.
That are clothed in.
With strange apparel.
Strange apparel. What's an apparel? That's your clothing, right? He said he's going to punish those in strange apparel. So the same way, if he come back and he see a whole group of men in dresses, he's going to punish them. He's going to see a whole group of women in pants, he's going to punish them. But guess what? We were never taught that, right? Because we didn't know that. Why? Because the churches are not set up to teach our people.
Right.
The churches are set up to make us go in there and feel good, give some money, and then go home.
That's right.
We sing a couple songs, we dance, we give money, and then we go home. And then you ask, hey, what you learn in church today? I learned that God's good. I learned that he loved me. I learned a new song. You know what I'm saying? I learned that they got a new bigger plate for money. They got a bigger one, you know, because we giving them more money. Because as you know better, you do better. The churches are not set up to teach us, because the same people who brought us over here on slave ships, killed us, stole the land, they'll set up the churches and say, hey, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal. There's a trick bag in that, V. There's a trick bag in that. No, now you got to go, V. Remember, you have to have time for God, right? You do, right? Five more minutes? You got five more minutes for God? Come on, V. Come on, V. One more, five more minutes. Give me one more. Give me one more, V.
I can't.
Why not?
I'm on a time frame.
That's savvy, because God give time for you all the time, but when it comes to you giving time for him, you got to go. You on a time frame. You better pray that God not on a time frame with you. Get Psalms 119. I made haste. Let's see if God on a time frame, because he is. So you better pray that God time frame fits your schedule. Where he said, I made haste. Psalms 119, 51, 59.
Psalms chapter 119, verse 59. I thought on my ways.
You have to think on your ways, V. Read.
And turn my feet unto thy testimonies. I made haste.
He said he did what?
I made haste.
He made haste to turn to the testimony of the Most High. Because why? He doesn't know what God's time frame for him is. He doesn't understand what God's time frame for him is. You have to make haste in order to go back to the commandments of God. You can't wait because you don't know when your time is coming. You can't delay turning back to God in the faith of Jesus Christ. You have to do that thing. You cannot wait. Give me Matthew 24. Give me Matthew 24, because the only reason why we think that's okay, because we've been sold a lie. We've been sold a false doctrine. We've been sold a false God. We think that the God that of the Bible is this all-loving, he's going to run back down, come on the earth, and run through the meadows with Ahmadinejad and Donald Trump and Joe Biden. He's going to be holding hands with them. The God of the Bible is not coming down to rule beside Joe Biden. He's not coming down to rule beside Donald Trump and Vladimir Putin. He's coming over here to restore order on the earth. But what have we been taught? A false God. Read.
Matthew chapter 24, verse 24. For there shall arise false Christ.
We've been taught a false Christ inside this society. Because Christ warned us. He said there's going to arise false Christ. Read.
And false prophets.
There's going to be false prophets teaching the false Christ, telling you that God is coming back to do all those things. That telling you that it's okay for you to come as you are and stay as you are. You have to change in the eyes of God. What did Christ himself say? Get Matthew 5 and 48. What did Christ himself say for us to do? Instead of listening to man's mouth, go through the Bible and see what God says.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect.
You have to strive for perfection in the eyes of God. You have to make sure that you are acceptable in the eyes of God. You can't just stay inside your worldly ways. Stay inside wickedness. You have to change. You have to change your doings. You have to make haste to come back to the word of God. That's what you have to do. He said, what?
Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect.
It says, be ye therefore perfect. What is perfect according to the Bible? What is perfect according to God? Give me that in Psalms 19. God gives you the definition of what it means to be perfect in his eyes. The same way that King David was. The same way that Job was. Solomon was. Read.
Psalms chapter 19 and verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect.
The laws of God are perfect. Thou shalt not kill is a perfect law. Thou shalt not steal is a perfect law. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Be covetous. Keep the Sabbath day. Honor thy father and mother. These are all perfect laws. That's how you be perfect in the eyes of God, when you're keeping his commandments. Because why? These are they that have the patience of the... This is the patience of the saints. Get that. Revelations 14 and 12. This is the patience of the saints. We're going to the book of Revelation to show you that this is what the people in the end are doing. Read.
Revelations chapter 14 and verse 12. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus.
These are the people that keep the commandments of God and have the faith of Jesus. It requires both. They'll tell you that you just need to have one. Just having faith in Christ. But you don't have to have any works. But faith without works is dead. There's something that you have to do to display your love for Christ. Can you say that you love Christ and be a murderer? Can you say that you love Christ and steal? Can you say that you love Christ and sell drugs to your community? Can you do that? No, you cannot do that. So there's something that you have to do to display that you love Christ. Display that you love God. It comes with a certain work. Read.
And I heard a voice from heaven. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus.
It said, here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. But we're not taught that inside these churches. There's a church on every corner in Greenville. But yet the communities are still trash. So what does that mean? The churches aren't doing anything for the people. You can't go three blocks without seeing a church. So why is there still drugs being sold? Why is there still murders? Why is there still killing? Why is there still gang violence? Why is there still single-parent households? Why is there still fathers abandoning their children? Why? Because the churches are not set up to teach you to do better.
Right.
Otherwise, there would be a change.
That's right.
Why can't you see a church on every corner in this state and the community is still garbage? The Bible says it's supposed to change your mind, a quickening spirit. I don't see no quickening around here. I still see the same old stuff going on. Get Isaiah 56. Let's see what these churches are doing. Let's see what these pastors are doing. Because you can't look inside your community and see that it's still trash and think that God is with us. We have to understand that we have not understood the love of God. We have not understood the ways of God. So we have to seek out the ways of God and change our ways and change our communities. We have to do it as the men and step up. We have to do that. Read.
Isaiah chapter 56 and verse 10. His watchmen are blind. They are all ignorant.
The watchmen inside these churches are blind. They are all ignorant. They cannot see. The blind leading the blind. Read.
They are all dumb dogs.
The watchmen inside these churches are all dumb dogs. What is a dog supposed to do? When you have a dog, it's supposed to warn you of danger. When you see somebody in your yard, the dog is supposed to bark. When they hear something, the dogs are supposed to bark. It says they are dumb dogs, read.
They cannot bark.
They cannot bark. The pastors inside these churches cannot warn you of the dangers that you're in. The pastors inside these churches are not warning you of the sin that you are in, read.
Lying down. Loving to slumber.
Instead, they lie down and love to slumber. You ever had a lazy dog that just let somebody inside your yard and don't bark and don't warn you? That's what these pastors inside these churches in Greenville are. Right?
Yay! They are greedy dogs.
But what one thing they are greedy dogs. A dog that always wants food. They always want their money. They always want your tithes. But then they'll tell you at the same time, oh, we don't have to do that. That's the Old Testament. The Old Testament done away with. Well, tithing's in the Old Testament, and they want to do that. That's why it says they're dumb dogs, ignorant, greedy, read.
Which can never have enough.
And they can never have enough. They always have a building fund. They always have a passenger van fund. They always have a land fund. They always have something, but you never see the fruits of it. That's why they can never have enough, read.
And they are shepherds that cannot understand. They all look to their own way.
They're shepherds that can't understand. When it comes to the truths of this Bible, that you have to keep the commandments and faith of Christ, they get dumb on you. They act stupid. They can't understand, read.
They all look their own way, every one for his gain.
They all look for their own gain.
What is nation? Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is men leading by example. Nation is women's support. Nation is children with role models.